Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. If you use two or more screens with your Mac, you need to know about this one setting. So often I hear from Mac users that have two or more displays connected to their Mac, and they complain that they can't have a window go from one display to another. A window seems to only be able to exist on a single display. But there's a setting for this, and the setting is hard to find if you don't know what you're looking for. So to demonstrate what I mean, here I've got two displays, and I've got my primary display on the right, and here's a notes window. If I move the note over past the edge here, you could see it kind of pop into that other display, but if I release from dragging, you could see the left side is not there on the second display. I could move it further over, and the left side's still not there. If I bring it all the way over to the other window, so my pointer is actually in the other window, then it's in the left display, and the right side is cut off and not on the right. There doesn't seem to be any way to get this window to stay where you see one part of it in one display and one part in another. But there is a setting that does exactly that. It's in System Settings, and you go to Desktop and Dock, since it deals with how the desktop works. If you scroll to the bottom of this, under Mission Control, there's the Displays Have Separate Spaces setting. It's just a simple toggle on or off, and it's exactly what controls this behavior. But of course, you could be excused for not recognizing that this is the setting you need to go to because it's talking about spaces, which is part of Mission Control. So for instance, I'll bring up Mission Control using the default keyboard shortcut, Control Up arrow, but you can use the trackpad gesture if you like. And you could see here at the top, it shows desktop one. Notice how over on my second display on the left, it also shows a desktop there, but it's calling that desktop two. And there are no available windows in that right now. Let's go ahead and add another desktop here on my right side display. And you can see now it labels that as desktop two. Over here, we still have desktop two, but actually if we leave Mission Control and go back in, you could see it's really desktop three. So the setting displays have separate spaces is being very true here. Desktop one and two are here on the right display and desktop three is on the left display. If I were to put a window, like let's say this pages window here on the left display and go into Mission Control, you can see how pages is here in desktop three on the left display and System Settings is here in desktop one on the right display, and there's nothing on desktop two. If I move back and forth between desktops on the right side display using Control and then left and right arrows, you could see it doesn't affect the left display. The left display just has this one desktop here, and I can have it create another desktop, and then it would just go between these two on the left side. Each display acts independently and has its own spaces. And remember, spaces are more than just desktops. If I were to take this window here full screen like that, you could see now it's a full screen space. So I have two desktop spaces and a full screen space. I could also have two apps in a split view space. So there are three different types of spaces, desktop, full screen, and split view. But whichever ones you're using, they exist independently on each display. You can drag a space, like let's say this full screen space, from one display to the other by clicking and dragging over. And now I've moved it over here. And you could see now I've got three spaces here on the right and two on the left. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. But let's take a look at how this works. If you turn off Displays Have Separate Spaces, when I do that, I get a little message here saying requires logout. You can't just switch this on or off and have everything change. You have to switch it and then you go to log out and log out of your account and then log back in. And now you'll see this take effect. So now once I've logged back in, you can see now I have Displays Have Separate Spaces turned off. So now watch what happens if I take a window like this and I move it between displays. I can leave it there and you could see one half of the window on one display and one half on the other. Now, it's not that useful on an app like System Settings, but let's go into Pages here. And with Pages, I can move this window over here and let's say put it on the left, and then drag the bottom right-hand corner all the way across the displays and have it appear like that. I can then zoom in and make the text really big if I want. A better example would be, say, in Numbers, a large spreadsheet with many tables on one display, but I could drag the corner here and have it cover both screens like that, and you can see now I could see everything. A more typical example would be to use some tool that has lots of parts to the window, like Final Cut Pro. Final Cut Pro stretched across two displays, you can see how I get a lot more real estate in each of the sections here. And since there's a long timeline all along the bottom, I can see much more of it with two displays. My two displays are right next to each other, like you see here. It really can make it feel like one long display. Or you could simply use it like this, where maybe you have one app's window covering more than one display, but not all the way across them. And then you still have room for another app, like maybe Notes, in a portion of one of the displays. When you have displays that have separate spaces turned off, if I bring up Mission Control, you can see it comes up for both screens and it just shows desktop. If I add a second desktop, that appears for both screens as well. These act as one long display instead of two separate displays. So if I were to switch desktops using Control right arrow and Control left arrow, you could see how it affects both displays at the same time because each shares one wide space. So for instance, if I were to put system settings here on my left display and pages on my right display and switch desktops to the second one, you could see how it's just one desktop one that has those two windows on it stretched across two displays. And now I'm on desktop two, which stretches across two displays and has neither one of those windows. When you have displays that have separate spaces turned on, you get the menu bar on both displays. And here, the main window is system settings, so I see the menu bar with system settings. Over on the left side, the main window is pages, and you could see that the menu bar reflects that. So I have two menu bars, but notice one of them is always grayed out. It's always inactive because you could only have one frontmost window. Like right now, it's system settings, and then I can switch over to pages. This is important, of course, because the menu bar determines keyboard shortcuts. So whichever menu bar is the active one is the one that will receive those keyboard shortcuts. Likewise, with the dock, you get the dock on either display. So if I were to move my pointer down to the bottom here, you can see the dock pops up there at the bottom. If I go to the other display and I move down to the bottom, the dock pops up there. If you go to dock settings and then you change it so that the dock doesn't automatically hide or show, you can see it's always there. Now getting it to appear on the other side is a little quicker. It will just change if you move your pointer down to the bottom. If you have displays have separate spaces turned off, notice the menu bar here at the top. It's only at the top of one display. It's not at the top of the other display at all, even though you can't actually drag a window across. If you try, the menu bar on the second display gets in the way like that. I can't push this window through. I have to go down and underneath it. And if I try to stretch the window across, you can see I can only have it as high as the menu bar here. It's kind of wasted space at the top. To control which display shows the menu bar, all you need to do is go into displays and then go to arrange. And then here you'll be able to arrange your displays. You're probably familiar with this if you have two or more displays. And you get this menu bar area here at the top. You can drag that around and it will decide which display is the main display, the one that has the menu bar. Also, the dock will appear here where the menu bar is. So on the display on the right, it won't appear here on the left. The dock is only on the main display like that. Now you can go into full screen mode if displays have separate spaces is turned off. But watch what happens when you do. I'll click the green button here and you could see that it's full screen mode on the display where the window was originally. What's on the other display? Nothing. I can move my pointer over to it, but it's just black. There's nothing there. I can turn this off and it goes back to normal. If I were to move this over to this display and go to full screen, you could see my right side display is now black. So full screen mode works but it makes the other display completely blank. It is useful if you just want to focus on one app, like just get some writing done, but you have displays have separate spaces turned off because otherwise you're usually editing video and you want things to stretch across screens. So there is a use for it, but it doesn't work nearly as well as when displays have separate spaces is on and you can have a full screen app on either display. Likewise, notice that there is no split view here. Split view is not available in this mode. You have to have displays have separate spaces turned on for that. Another thing that is missing is Stage Manager. If you click on Control Center here, you'll see Stage Manager missing from that. And if you look here in System Settings, under Desktop and Dock for Stage Manager, you'll see that the toggle is permanently off and it tells you it requires displays of separate spaces to be enabled. So here's a chart showing the two different modes and what you can do with each mode. So you basically need to decide which function you want more. If you want a window to stretch across multiple displays, then you need to turn off displays have separate spaces. However, when you do, you lose a lot of functionality. The menu bar will only be on one display. The dock will only be on that one display. You don't have separate spaces across the screens, just one set of spaces, and you switch both displays at the same time. You also can't use split view. You can't use Stage Manager. And when you do use full screen windows, it displays only on one display at a time, not both. But then stretching the window across both displays gets you something very close to having full screen across both displays. And while it is difficult to switch the setting because you have to log out and then back in, it really doesn't take that long. So if you want to use this every once in a while, say to edit a video in Final Cut Pro, it's not that difficult to switch it, log out, log back in, and then work for a few hours in Final Cut Pro to finish a project, and then switch it back on, log out, log back in to use your Mac with all of your other apps in the regular mode. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.